What's this? A late 1980s zombie movie I had not seen, much less heard of? Oh, this is good. Where is it? 1989's The Chilling opens up in an American location known for its ice and dead people, Kansas City, Missouri. There, a cryogenics lab is busy making bucks of a promise. You will live after death. The process here is to freeze corpses, suck out the blood, and then fill them with green goo, very scientific, holding the bodies in stasis until they can one day be thawed. Whether they can fix whatever killed these people, like being riddled with bullets, that's tomorrow's problem. Quit asking questions. Shut up. Oh, one more thing. The company's also selling all the organs of the dead, but we're sticking them in the freezer. Not sure how you're going to be thawed in 2121 without your heart, but again, that's a tomorrow people problem. Suckers. So, things are running smoothly like this until Halloween, when a storm knocks out the power to the facility. Two underpaid, overdrunk, and overambitious security guards move the corpse containers outside because it's colder than the inside, duh. Well, trouble quite literally strikes again in the form of lightning, which zaps the canisters, animates the green goo, and causes the dead inside to pop out. Looking like potatoes that got microwaved while wrapped in tin foil, these crinoid creatures start stalking the facility and munching on anyone they can find. Wow, that's a lot of plot and setup, right? Oh, just wait. That's the biggest problem with The Chilling. It can't decide if it's a serious anti-cryogenics movie or a wacky zombie flick or something else, and it won't stop talking about it. The opening is truly bizarre, with a long Star Wars-like text scroll about cryogenics that could absolutely be read by Criswell the Psychic. I quote, "The story you are about to see could occur in your own community." And what if things were to go wrong? The moral and technical dilemmas are obvious. We ask you, would God approve, or is this Satan's work? I thought this was a scary movie. Why are you preaching, Abby? Would God approve of your shitty movie? Were people really this worried about cryogenics? It's bizarre. And then the film's like, just kidding, because right after this very serious text, we see a series of cryo tanks that show the names Chaplin, Disney, Michael Jackson. You get the idea, like, it's just trying to be silly now. What? I thought cryogenics was the devil's work movie, but here you are just joking about it. Jesus Christ. The movie then shows us probably the most unintentionally hilarious botched bank robbery in film.
Okay, you bastards, free! Oh. I'm out of here!
Ah. Don't shoot! Oh, she's dead!
Better go and drop your gun.
No, wait a minute! Seize my ticket out of here!
Solar punch! Give it up!
Up yours, Redicop!
This film is filled with ideas that are neat on paper, but they're executed with a budget that's also as thin as paper. One of these budget-saving items was forklifts. Forklifts feature prominently in the plot, with actors driving them with an ease that suggests that moving crates and forklifts and not acting is probably their day job. A forklift even delivers the most satisfying kill in the movie. Eat prongs, you zombie bastard! Now, in a good twist, The Chilling has scored at least two decent actors in Ted Haggerty and Linda Blair. The movie has a creepy, dark industrial setting, and it has some really fantastic monster makeup and special effects, which are worth the price of admission, kind of, sort of. Not really, but they're neat when they're there. It really is a shame. Discovering a movie, a zombie movie, I didn't know about is probably one of my favorite things to do in constantly searching for, cataloging, viewing, and reviewing movies. However, the more I discover these hidden titles, the more I've learned they're probably hidden for good reasons. Chilling is definitely not all bad, but holy moly, it is mostly bad. One moment you're going to be yelling at the film for being awful, the next you're going to be praising it for really being that awful. It's attained a certain type of bumbling that makes it enjoyable. So bad it's good, finally, I agree with that statement. Ranking right up there with amazing abominations like, well, we'll talk about that one later. I give The Chilling 2 crinoids out of 5. It might have been great if someone, anyone, could have burst into the office making this film and just told the creators, hey, stop trying so hard and just chill.